Naglasi ga naši Srbe prave događaje, uvek je nešto lepo. Evo Kathy Fenslow I naši Srbi pripremili su je nov lep događaj. Ovoga puta javljamo se iz sale crkve Sveti Ilija Merrillville Indiana I događaj se zove Potreban je vinograd. It takes a vinograd. Kathy, congratulations, another beautiful event. It's called It takes a vinograd. You always have some nice new ideas and it looks like by turnout people love
Wonderful.
The idea. What's going on? Can you tell us what's going on today?
Well, today was... It's really funny because we have so many Indiana on the board people.
Yeah.
And we were having a meeting and one of them said, well, you know, we never do anything in Indiana and on and on and on. And I said, hey, I'm all for it. Put it together. So four of them put it totally together. And they did majority of this. I helped with the auction and stuff. But they did all of this, the four of them.
So this is a wine tasting, food, music, socializing, everything in one package, so to speak. And of course, as always, it goes for a good cause. What, how would you describe what's going on today? What do we have?
Really, our new project, which is fantastic, awesome. We're building houses in Medveja for families. And somebody approached me, one of the priests approached me when I was there for Christmas, and they were given land, the municipality gave them the land, and they can build 40 houses for families.
So they got the land, but our Serbs are going to finance
Serbs,
the building of the houses?
Two houses. And it's really cute because I got to tell you a story. One of the people from Serb for Serbs, which I admire very much, had called and said, is it true that our Serbs are building two houses? And the priest said, yeah, it is. So they said, well, we can't let that happen. We're going to build a third house. So they're building the third house.
So you're kind of giving inspiration to others to join you and make it an even bigger event.
It would be wonderful if all our organizations... It takes $40,000 to build it completely.
So you'll pay $80,000?
Yeah.
From our Serbs funds?
Yeah. And this
is... Do you also give your personal funds or is it practically our Serbs?
I'm going to work for the Serbs and I think it's going to be fine. Yeah. We managed to be able to do that.
So this is the first time that you're doing something like this specifically, actually building the houses?
Building the village or whatever is going to be. You know, like they say, one of our first ladies says it takes a village. And these are families that live anywhere and nowhere. So it's a 99 land lease for the families.
So 99 years they can use it.
Right. They can't sell it. They can't do any such thing. But they could continue for their family and family after.
And do you know which families these are going to be? Have they been selected yet?
The church is going to do that.
Because local
they
church
know,
in Medveja?
Yeah, they know the people. And I've been working with them for so long now that I trust thoroughly what they tell us. When they give us families that are in dire need and we go there.
Is this a Serbian Orthodox church there in Medveja?
Yeah. Our church.
So the funds today, is everything going to be going to that project?
Yeah, and being that they had gotten someone to put in a full kitchen for each one of these houses, we are going to add furniture. And that's part of what's over there. I've got pictures of what's needed to furnish this little house so that people that are here, you know, they could donate to buy a sofa, to buy a bed, to buy a kitchen cabinet or whatever.
Do you know how long it'll take to build the houses? When is the construction starting?
Well, this is what's funny is I had said to him, if we come to an agreement, I said, when will this house be ready, the first house? And he said, I think by June. I said, okay. I'm coming to go to Kosovo in June like I always do. So if you build the house in June, and we can hand over the key to the family, I'll buy a second house. So that's how the second house came up.
Oh, wonderful. So that's going to be pretty fast.
They like. And there's a picture over there, Alex, of them breaking ground with the brick and all that they started already.
So they're already working on it as we speak.
Yeah, yeah.
What kind of, so we'll see, the house, is there like a certain size or requirements? Or
they're small houses, and I believe they're working for 2 bedrooms, because, you know, with our people in need, they could put 5 kids in 1 bedroom.
Yeah.
So, yeah, 2 bedrooms, I think, is what they could do. And my thought is, oh my God, next time we could build them a little greenhouse like we built. And they could put it back of their house, and they could grow their own vegetables.
So they have some food there, too.
Yeah.
Really
yeah.
becoming self-sustaining, like you usually try to do, actually.
Yeah.
That's great. How do you feel about that? That's something new for our Serbs, building an actual house, 2 houses.
I feel wonderful. I think it's one of those. I always wanted to build something, because we built for the recovery.
And you made a paycheck. Porfiry, he was also in Indiana, nearby in Merrillville, back just a couple months ago. So how did it feel to meet him on this side of the world, this time across the ocean?
It was wonderful. I said to him, welcome to my world. And thank God we have a really nice relationship. You know, we did with Patriarch.
Irine.
Thank you. He's proud of what we do.
Yeah, definitely was nice. I think he had great reception here at Merrillville in Chicago and Wisconsin, Milwaukee. So he was able to see quite a few people who were very, very happy to see him. What is going on today? There's some wine tasting and some food, and how is this day working?
It's so far so good. I mean, the girls sold out all the tickets. And like I say, the Indiana group did it.
And how does this work, though? When somebody kind of comes in, pays the admission, they get a wine tasting, and they can also provide.
We have these little Serbian glasses.
And our Serbs logo on it.
Our Serbs. And they get the wine, and then they get to keep the glass.
And then they can also make an extra donation. There's a silent auction.
Fabulous items on the auction.
We'll take a look. And then people have some food also in the meantime.
Oh, yes. Alex Lazic is the one that was kind enough to donate the food, so we're grateful. He's wonderful. He's on our board.
So it's a team effort in that sense. And this is one of the, because of Corona, he couldn't do as many events. Hopefully that's really over. So now, and let's say also May 7th, there'll be one in Lake Forest, but also a bigger one in September. Maybe we should start announcing that soon.
September 9th is we're going back to the boats. Everybody loves the boat, and they've been asking us to do it, which we had to with the COVID and all that, we couldn't do. But now, and it's a smaller ship where it's like a private yacht, and it's going to be awesome.
Is it possible that it's going to be almost 4 years since 2019, since the previous cruise for cause already?
Yeah.
How is that going to, how is that evening going to look like? For people coming, they'll also have some food and dancing and donations.
They have dancing, of course, they have the food. It's going to be great. It's going to be great.
Well, here, you have some great ideas. A beautiful afternoon here, obviously.
Wonderful.
People like it.
Yeah, yeah. And I love that the Indiana girls did it. I love it.
Yeah, a lot of them are already active in our service.
They did a great job.
They're preparing
because when I told them, do something, get it together, I said, I know nothing of Indiana. I don't know the areas other than a few places I've been. So they did all this.
And they have a nice facility, a very nice church here, Sveti Ilija. Beautiful social hall. This is a smaller hall. They have a bigger hall and the church and the parking.
Yeah.
Very nice. Great. Very nice.
So you come September 9th?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
I'm gonna come.
All right, I got a mix, Alex.
Okay, well, thanks, Kathy. And June also going to Serbia?
I go on the 7th, and we leave for Kosovo on the 11th.
Are you somebody else going with you? I mean,
yeah, one of our board members, Alex.
Alex Lazic.
She is coming with us. She was with me last time. 2 years ago she came with me. And she came to me two weeks ago, and said, I want to go again. So far, it's her. Whoever else wants to go.
Right, so May 7th in Lake Forest and September 9th, about ourserbs.org is the place to get information. And soon we'll have a new member who will be doing some social media stuff too, to alert people. We'll say more about it later. Thanks so much, Kathy.
Thank you, Alex.
Evo da gledalci, ovo je događaj humanizacije naše Srbije. Ovde je u prostorijama u društvene sale Crkve Sveti Ilije u Merrillville, jedna od najlepših srpskih crkvi i imanja u Americi, sigurno sa predivnim salama. Ovo je čokštor imanja, tu je veća sala, predivna crkva, parking i sve što potrebno. Evo, otac Aleksandar Novaković je ovde sveštenik već sad, možda ja mislim, dobrih 14, uplike godine sam,
15
godina, tako ima. I danas, evo, kako ocenjujete ove događaje? Prvi put danas u sebi ovde organizuju događaje kod vas u crkvenoj sali.
Jeste, pre svega Hristos Voskrese, želim da pozdravim sve vaše gledalce, da se zahvalim na pažnji koju uvek činite i na redovnim izveštavanjima koji su jako bitni u vezi sa ovakvim humanitarnim događajima koji se dešavaju na ovim prostorima. Večeras sam zaista blagodaran organizaciji Naši Srbi za njihov napor, za njihov rad, za njihovu ljubav, za njihovu žrtvu na prvom mestu, i to je jedan veliki blagoslov za sve naše crkvene zajednice ovde, da na neki način i mi možemo da budemo deo toga, deo organizacije humanitarne, i da možemo da zajednički snagama pomažemo sve one kojima je pomoć danas potrebna. Naši Srbi su ovde jako dobro zastupljeni i njihov plan, njihov rad se vrednuje, i zato sam blagodaran da učestvujem u njihovim projektima i na njihovim humanitarnim događajima zajedno sa svojom porodicom, zajedno sa parohijanima naše Svete crkve, ali zajedno sa svim ljudima dobre volje koji žele da pomognu kako decu, tako i sve one kojima je pomoć potrebna. Zato je ovaj događaj sam po sebi veličanstven i uvek pozitivan, i nadam se da ćemo i u buduće imati dobru saradnju i volju, i da ćemo svi činiti što je do nas da naši Srbi opstanu kao organizacija i da što više pomognu ljudi kojima je danas pomoć potrebna.
Evo, baš iz vaše parohije ima ljudi koji su već, žena koji su već članovi organizacije i aktivni, i baš u vrhu vaše, da kažemo, parohija i vrhu organizacije Naši Srbi, tako da su se povezali ovoga puta zajednički ovde.
Jeste, mnogo mi je drago da imamo mlađih ljudi koji su jako zainteresovani za dobročinstvo, to je jedna predivna naša riječ, da i mi nešto svi damo od sebe za ideje koje su vrlo bitne i za pomoć koja je neophodna, pogotovo našim ugroženim ljudima širom sveta. Naša parohija zaista ima mlade ljude koji su željni ovakvih jednih događaja, ali ono što razdvaja sve organizacije jeste upravo cilj. Ono što naši Srbi imaju za cilj, a to smo i mi malo i ovde više prepoznali, to je svakako da se obezbedi pomoć našim ljudima na Kosovu i Metohiji, ali i u svim drugim mestima gde je zaista pomoć potrebna, raznim domaćinstvima, kroz razne projekte. Ovo ne je naš prvi projekat humanitarni, ali svakako jeste jedan ovakve vrste, i nadam se da će jedna mlada snaga ljudi koji sazrijeva u crkvi i u našim zajednicama biti upravo onaj pokretač svih dobrih i pozitivnih humanitarnih akcija u budućnosti.
Pa nadamo se da će se i novi ljudi uključiti u ovakve projekte. Ono što je interesantno, naši Srbi obično i ne šalju gotovinu, nego žele da stave familije na svoje noge, da dugoročno im pomognu. Evo sad zidaju kuće, nekada staklene bašte, kupe kravu, znači neke stvari koje će familija omogućiti da privređuje mesecima i godinama, u stvari.
Svakako, to su divni projekti da se ljudima pomognu da opstanu na svojim vjekovnim ognjištima, da im se pomognu da malo stanu na noge i da mogu da prehrane svoje porodice. Zaista, kada pogledamo razna mesta od Kosova, Metohije, Srbije, Bosne, Like, Dalmacije i svih naših zemalja vidimo da ima mnogo ljudi kojima je zaista pomoć potrebna. Ono što mene raduje jeste da ima ljudi koji to prepoznaju, da se žrtvuju za takve ideale, a mi smo tu da ih podržimo, da pomognemo i da budemo sa njima u prvim redovima, jer ukoliko i mi damo svoj maksimum, siguran sam da ćemo na neki način usrećiti mnoge porodice sa raznim projektima koji se budu nudili ovdje svakako u našim zajednicama. Mi smo razne projekte i već ostvarili sa našim Srbima, ali i samostalno, tako da verujem da će ova organizacija kao i sve druge organizacije biti u prilici da usreće i da pomognu pojedinim porodicama da opstanu i da svoju decu svakako usmere na pravi put.
I našim ljudima ovdje, možda ni ovdje nije uvijek svima lako, u Americi ljudi imaju opterećenja i financije, evo i razdešavaju, ali ipak vjerujem da svakom lep osjećaj, znajući koliko za relativno malo sredstava odavde mogu da pomognu tamo, da ovom slučaju izrade celu kuću za dve familije. Znači, vjerujem da je i svima koji su došli danas to je veoma lep osjećaj, da mi je srce puno zbog toga.
Svakako, svakako. Ovdje su ljudi jako osjetljivi, to ste prelepo primijetili, osjetljivi za dobročinstvo. I uvijek kada razmišljamo o ovakvim događajima, setim se našeg velikog pesnika i akademika Matije Bećkovića, koji je jednom prilikom rekao: oni koji su otišli najdalje, ostali su najbliže. Tako i ovi ljudi, iako su otišli daleko od Srbije, preko okeana, žive ovdje u ovim stvarima, njihovo srce je ostalo vezano za Srbiju i siguran sam da je u njihovom srcu Srbija i naš narod urezan duboko i da će ovi ljudi dati sve od sebe da ti projekti obnove kuća, stimulacija porodica da opstanu na svojim vekovnim ognjištima, pomoć deci biti nešto što ćemo ispuniti u našoj budućnosti i što će se dešavati češće nego što je to bila prilika do sada.
Interesantno, ovdje ima ljudi koji možda nisu godinama bili u Srbiji, možda neko čak i nikad, i tu su i rođeni, došli su im babe i dede ovdje, ali svi istom snagom i energijom žele da pomognu.
Pa jeste, ono što sam naučio kroz ceo ovaj period jeste da dobre stvari spajaju dobre ljude. I oni ljudi koji imaju široko srce za druge, oni osete tu potrebu i priliku, i kada čuju za jedan ovakav sadržaj, za jedan ovakav događaj, za jednu ovakvu namjenu, oni svakako žele da otvore svoje srce za nas. I ovdje su sigurno večeras neki ljudi koji žele samo svojim prisustvom, normalno i svoje mogućnosti, da pomognu rad ove organizacije Naši Srbi, ali da pomogne i projekte sve koji su započeti i koji će biti ispunjeni u skorijoj budućnosti.
Samo spitamo da li nešto drugo ima da najavimo u parohiju Crkve Narodnih nedelja i mjeseci, da iskoristimo razgovor s vama?
Pa da, naša parohija kao i uvijek vrlo je aktivna, dinamična, prepuna događaja. Od mjeseca maja, kada se završava naša crkvena škola nedeljna, koja spada svakako u jedne od najboljih i najorganizovanijih škola, s obzirom da imamo ozbiljne ljude koji se bave prosvetom, svakako već na leto dolaze novi izazovi, dečji kamp u našoj parohiji.
Kad će to otprilike biti?
To će da bude početkom jula, krajem juna, početkom jula. To je jedan prelep događaj koji uvijek budi jednu novu energiju, novu nadu. Nova deca dolaze, stasavaju, druže se, upoznajemo ih sa svim značajnim učenjima naše crkve, ali također i otvaramo svoje srce, otvaramo mogućnost da deca prepoznaju da su u ovoj zajednici našoj kao kod svoje kuće. Također ove godine bit će tradicionalni golf turnir, to je jedan događaj koji organizuje Srpski narodni savez. Svake godine ovaj događaj se dešava u različitim crkvenim zajednicama, gradovima, a po cijeloj Americi i Kanadi. Ove godine smo mi domaćini i ako Bog da, od 2. avgusta do 5. avgusta bit ćemo domaćini ovog jednog, da kažemo, svenarodnog događaja, jer dolaze mnogi ljudi iz Kanade, cele Amerike i mi smo spremni za gostoprimstvo i svakako ono što nam je uvijek bio cilj jeste da budemo dobri domaćini. Pored toga imamo i našu crkvenu slavu koja će se održati u mjesecu u avgustu.
Ali će se poklopiti sa početkom golfa 2. augusta.
Golf će biti od četvrtka srede do srede četvrtka do subote, a onda u nedjelju krunisat ćemo s ceo jedan taj događaj sa proslavom naše crkvene slave, koja je svake godine svakako jedan prelep duhovni događaj koji sve nas spaja. I normalno u julu ćemo imati i naše srpske dane, o kojima ste već izvještavali, 3 dana koji traju i zaista zahtevaju jedan veliki napor, veliki broj ljudi dolazi u ovu našu sredinu i veliki broj naših parohijana radi na tome da budemo dobri domaćini, da pokažemo i predstavimo našu kulturu, da predstavimo ono ko smo, šta smo, a s drugim ljudima, to jeste Amerikancima i svim onim drugim nacijama koji žive ovdje u okolini, koji dolaze i zaista osjećaju potrebu da budu na srpskim danima, da dođu u dodir sa srpskom kulturom, ali također i da nam se zahvale na svemu onom što i mi radimo za ovu okolinu i za sve ono što činimo da celokupna ova zajednica bude ono što jeste.
Imali novi ljudi koji dolaze u zajednicu i da pozovemo i druge koji možda nisu postali parohiju?
Pa jeste, ovom prilikom pozivamo, naša vrata crkvenog doma su širom otvorena, ali ono što je još važnije, naše srce je otvoreno za svakoga. Ovi krajevi nisu toliko, da kažem, ispunjeni tom idejom dolaska novih ljudi, ali u zadnje vrijeme i to se dešava s obzirom na sve ekonomske prilike. Ova sredina postaje vrlo dobra, tako da ljudi prepoznaju, pogotovo koji imaju porodice, da dolaze u ovaj severno-zapadni deo Indijane, da se naseljavaju i svakako prvo što je najvažnije jeste prelepe crkve i zajednice koje imamo na ovom području. Crkva Svetog proroka Ilije je jedna od njih i zato ih pozivamo. Naša vrata i naše srce su uvijek otvoreni za njih i dovedite ono što je najvažnije, svoju decu da budu i da odrastaju u jednoj crkvenoj zajednici, tako će, siguran sam, postati bolji i čestitiji ljudi. Da ne propustimo priliku, jer kao roditelj to i govorim, vreme brzo prolazi, deca sazrijevaju mnogo brže nego što mi mislimo i ukoliko uložimo taj napor, bit ćemo srećni i blagosloveni jednog dana da vidimo plodove našeg rada, naše vere i našeg odricanja.
Da ih ne izgubimo, jer oni koji kad dođu do vas, tako dalje, koji nisu bili u crkvama sa Srbima i tako, mogu se otisnuti druge sredine i, da kažem, nažalost zaboraviti njihovo poreklo.
Svakako, to je jedno veliko i ozbiljno pitanje za sve nas u dijaspori i mi se trudimo koliko je to u našoj mogućnosti da odgovorimo na te izazove na jedan svoj pastirsko-misionarski način, ali svakako poruka da deca koja nisu i naslonjena, da kažem, i usmjerena na bilo koju crkvenu zajednicu izgube neku tokom vremena neku povezanost sa svojom kulturom, sa svojom crkvom, sa svojim prijateljima i jednostavno asimilacija učini svoje i oni onda odlaze nažalost u jednom drugom smeru, ali se nadam da ćemo naporima svih nas pa i ovih ljudi ovdje koji se večeras nalaze prevazići i prevazići ove probleme i ove izazove i svakako ljudima predstaviti ovaj naš program, predstaviti sve naš trud i omogućiti im da decu svoju usmere na naše zajednice i da njihova deca stasaju i da budu dobri i čestiti ljudi i da vole svoj narod, da vole svoju crkvu i da vole svoju državu.
We'd also like to thank our lovely savory charcuterie, I always say that wrong, our savory charcuterie table, which was donated by Lazic Deli and Catering, Harzek's Sausage Company. So, I mean, it's wonderful. So, And then we also want to thank all of those here who are tonight here with us who donated all the desserts as well. So thank you. I'd also like to recognize our musician this evening, Mr. George Chalakovich. There he is in the back. So our wonderful, I asked him, as I said, hey George, do you think you can come play some piano, some jazz music for us? And he's like, sure. So wonderful. Thank you very much, George. And then I just wanted to make sure everyone knows that the bar is open. So it is an open bar. So if you're want to take a break a little bit from some wines, then that's okay. So she's back there. So you can try some other things too. So that's available for you. So many of you have already probably noticed we have a silent auction table. Please go ahead and take a look at all those items. All of those items are also donated this evening. So if you'd like to, there's an opening bid there. Go ahead and put your name and phone number and whatever your bid is. If it's something you really want, pay attention to it because somebody might outbid you. So you might want to go back and check it again. But please take a look at our silent auction table. You also can see the slideshow that's playing. This is actually a lot of the things that have been happening this past year, right, Kathy?
Over
since Christmas. So these are all the lovely donations that our Serbs has supported. And
these are all food for the families.
These are the food for the families. And so there's a lot of stuff that I've just set it up so that you guys can kind of see what's going on with a lot of the things that we've been supporting over this past year and several years. So with that, I wanted to also tell you we've got a special project that we're really excited about and have started this year. And that is what these boards are about back here. So this is some homes that we're trying to raise funds for. And Kathy's going to be telling you guys a little bit more about that in a bit. So before we do that, I want to acknowledge the other board members that are here tonight. So if you could just kind of stand up and raise your hand so everybody knows you if they don't already know you. Veta Bielopetrovic. I don't know where that is. There she is. Anata Manavic. She's back there. Yasmin Kasharas. There she is. Alex Savic. There she is. Lynn Spielar. Donna Kasic. And Ivan Kasic. Sandy Wojtowicz, did I do okay? Vicky Zamiatelli. And then, of course, last but not least, our fearless leader, Kathy Fanslow. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Kathy. She's going to tell you a little bit more about this special project that we're working on for this year. She's going to tell you a little bit more about the boards. And then hopefully, I just hope everyone has a wonderful evening and enjoys it. Make sure all this stuff is gone by the end of the night. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. It's so wonderful to see everyone smiling. The sun is out because we're here. You know that, right? It rained earlier. So thank you all for being here. And before I get started, I have to tell you a little story. We were having a meeting, one of our meetings, and the girls from Indiana said, we never do anything in Indiana. We always do it in Chicago. So I said, you know what? Great. I don't know anything about Indiana. You're from Indiana. Do it. Put it together. And look what a fabulous job they did. Is this not fantastic? They actually did all of this, majority of all of this, the four of them. Wow. So we're very proud. We're very proud. And they did such a good job that on our next event, which is September 9th, they're going to be in charge again. Okay. I'm very proud of this organization. We do so many wonderful things. They're not big things, you know. We're not huge. We're little, but I think we're pretty mighty. And the responses that we get every year is awesome, unbelievable. I was there. I go every year for our Christmas, January, And then I go to Kosovo around June, which I'm going this year, June 7th. When I was there at Christmas, people usually want to meet you. They want to see how we could help them, what we could do. And one of the priests asked for a meeting, which I said, let's do it, because you know, you always want to know what's happening. And he came with this project. And I looked at it, and he said, we're building houses. And I, well, hey, we're not that big. I mean, you know. One thing led to another, and it's right on the border of Serbia and Medveja. These houses are going to be small houses for probably two bedroom that will cost $40,000 complete. The only thing they're going to need is furniture. And if you're able to look at some of these pictures here, are things that we are hoping that people will contribute to buy sofas and beds and things like that, that when we turn the key, that it's furnished for them. The interesting thing was, I said to him, okay, when will this house, the first house, be finished? And he said, about end of July, maybe July, end of June, maybe July. And I said, well, I'll tell you, I'm coming on beginning of June, and if you have the first house finished, we will buy the second house, which, believe it or not, they're going to have it ready when I go there. It's just wonderful, the connections that you get and the people that are in need. And by the way, one of my questions was, if we give this house, can they sell it? You know, I mean, some people may think that. As it turns out, it's going to be a 99 land lease, 99 years, which is great because whatever happens, it's their family that continues for 99 years. I'll probably be gone by then, but it'll be nice anyway. I think our supporters through all these years have been incredible. We started small. We're getting bigger all the time. We have some wonderful new members, and we have some old members that were with me way before. So I'm thrilled about that. What we normally do, we get food for the families when I go. Christmas time, we work with the patriarch, and we give 2,000 gifts at St. Saba. We feed our homeless people at least 2,000 dinners on Christmas Day with the patriarch. And I could sit and I could tell you forever what we do, but it's gonna be long, and I want you to have a good time. If anyone has any questions about our project, oh, big deal, I have to tell you this. Somebody from Serbs for Serbs, which is a very good organization, and they're big. I mean, we're nowhere near that. We will be, but not right now. But they called the priests and they said, we hear that our Serbs is building the first house. And the priest said, yes, yes they are. And they might even bring the second one. So the guy from the organization said, well, we can't let that happen. We're going to build a third house. So they're doing the third house. So it would be wonderful if we could reach out to, you know, all the Serbian organizations. There's quite a few of them. And this is not big money we're talking about. We're talking for a bed, you know, that's $200, or the sofa, $300. So these are the things that we could do. We're having a wonderful event on September 9th, and we would love for you to be there. We've done boats in the past, and then COVID hits us, so we couldn't do that for a while. But we're doing it again this year, and that's September 9th. Please put it in your calendar. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're taking a smaller ship than we normally do. So it's going to be like a private yacht that fits 150 people. So please look out for that. We're going to send you all the information once it all gets going, which will be this week. Anybody have any questions of us? Anybody?
Kathy, just tell me a little bit about how to do
it. Yeah, I will. Okay, all right. Behind us are the boards, and these are the, you have a choice of donating for the construction, for the furniture, for the kitchen, for everything, mattresses, groceries, everything that will be needed for these houses. So whatever you could do to help us, that would be wonderful. I have to introduce a special lady to my heart. Papalia Yelena, raise your hand. If you follow us, you have seen every year Gift of Joy, which Holy Resurrection is a huge, huge lady here that does all that. She started out with the nice donations from everybody. The next year, we had COVID, and I remember speaking with her and saying, you know, I don't know how much you're gonna get this year with COVID and everything. People need every penny they can have. She raised it by thousands. And then this last year for Christmas, she raised it even more. So I just want to tell you, we love you, we appreciate you, and thank you for being here. And now I would like to introduce a special person, and that's Father Alec.
You're mad.
Thank you, Kathy. Thank you, Rana. Thank you all members of our Serbs, and thank you all of you for coming tonight or today to this special event. This is the first time for me to be a part of this kind of the event in Northwest Indiana, and I'm blessed and proud that we can get together, set our goals and help our people. That's the purpose of all of us. And we are all blessed to have such a good leadership and young also people who are interested in doing different projects. And when you look this project, you only can say, yes, how I can help. And Kathy explained well, what I need to add is the only prayer. I can pray and we all can pray together to continue to do good things for our children and for our people, especially for our people in Kosovo and Metohija. I don't like to praise this community, but definitely like what they do at Redwood, we do here at St. Elijah Church too. And last Christmas, we accomplished also something very nice. We supported 8 children from Mountain Bobija in Serbia. They are left behind. 5 villages only have 5 children, walking every day 5 to 7 kilometers, at least 4 miles to the school through the good weather, bad weather, winter. So they were so happy and surprised that we supported them with different gifts. And this parish was a good example for it. I like to thank Cindy Stojic also, and all Rada and all those ladies involved in this project. And also, we all need to support our people in different ways. So may God bless you, may God help you to continue set the good example for all of us. We need to follow your goodness. And the moment that we get on that path, many windows in our life will be opened. So can you all stand up to the to say the prayer for success, and also to pray to say the prayer for support of our Serbs. Christos Voskrese. Oh. Svetom Duhu i nije i prisne vijek i vijeku, amin. Gospodi pomiluj, Gospodi pomiluj, Gospodi pomiluj. Gospode Isuse Hriste Bože naš, blagoslovi sabranje ovo tvojih dobrih ljudi i umnoži njihove napore i njihove želje svakda, sada i uvek i u vekove vekova. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, bless this gathering of your good people always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Živeli, još jedan put, hvala svima.
So I'm just going to, real quickly, if you guys are interested in the boards, so you can see Sandy and Vicky at the desk. And so once each line kind of represents the amount, so you can write a check, we can do credit cards or cash. And then we have markers over here, and we would love it if you would please come and fill out the line with your name, please. So that way, our goal is to try to get as much of this filled as possible.
And the wonderful auction.
And the auction, yeah. And make sure you pay attention to those, to those auction items. Thank you, everyone. Please enjoy.
Ivan Tašić je član uprave naših Srba od početka, skoro praktično od osnivanja organizacije. Kako se čini večeras ovaj događaj?
Lepo je, ovaj prvi put da smo u Severnoj Indijani organizovali ovaj događaj, jer nekako uvek smo u gradu ili severnije, pa je onda nekim ljudima teže da dođu, jer to je malo ovde drugačije. Ovde su razdaljine mnogo veće da bi neko prešao do druge crkve, recimo gde najčešće držimo ove proslave ili donatorske večere, to je obično stotinak kilometara i nama se to neka čini da je malo, u stvari nije malo. Tako da smo ovde sada okupili dosta veliki broj ljudi koji žive u ovom kraju. I stvarno je dobro, jer imamo jedan veoma dobar projekat na kome radimo. Pokušavamo da opremimo kuće u Medveđi, koje su za prilično siromašan narod. Tako da cilj je da ih opremimo svim neophodnim stvarima koje idu u kući, znači kuhinjom, nameštajem najosnovnijim, krevetima i ostalim priborom kojim treba da normalno žive. I cilj je da već krajem juna imamo prvu kuću potpuno opremljenu, a nakon toga nadamo se da će biti još.
Evo, interesantno, znači nešto u novi način. Znači, Srbije pokušavaju da ne daju gotovinu, ali da daju mogućnost ljudima dugoročno žive. Ovaj put bit će bare dve familije, znači usrećene, vidimo evo iza čak kućice, lepe, bit će da će nešto novo za njih. I da li sveštenici među vremenu biraju i predlažu koje familije bi predložili za to?
Da, da, u principu mi uvek radimo sa sveštenstvom, uvek imamo preporuke za vrlo konkretne osobe. Mi nikad ne skupljamo novac i ne baratamo novcem direktno, nego za sve što se prikupi pokupujemo sve što je neophodno. Ranije smo donirali kompjutere, donirali smo, na primer, stoku, najosnovnije ako neko živi na selu, ili sadnice, maline. Znači, cilj je da se obezbede uslovi da neko može da nastavi normalno da živi, makar u nekom pristojnom periodu dok stane na noge. I mi nismo organizacija koja daje, kao što sam rekao, gotovinu, nego isključivo ono što je potrebno, znači u fizičkom smislu. Ono što je takođe važno, mi imamo tim u Srbiji koji obilazi različite krajeve u zemlji i onda izaberemo šta je prioritetno i onda na taj način u dogovoru sa njima i sa crkvom određujemo šta možemo u stvari i da ispunimo, tako da nismo nerealni. Drugo, još jedna stvar koja je odlična za ovu organizaciju je što mi nemamo praktično nikakvih administrativnih troškova, to je potpuno donirano, tako da 100% svih sredstava koje se prikupe odlaze u donacije.
To je bitno, jer neke organizacije, čak i u Americi recimo, koje se bave donacijama, u stvari nekad ja mislim samo možda 10% od donacija prosvede dalje. Znači ovde neko ko želi da da pomoć možda zna da će praktično skoro sve ili sve da ide direktno.
Znači sve sa ovih tabli večeras, sve što se bude doniralo ići će pravo u donacije, znači ljudima kojima je to potrebno.
Ko su ljudi večeras koji su došli? Znači dosta ljudi koji su ovde, koji žive blizu ove parohije u Severnoj Indijani?
Da, ovde su, postoje dve parohije koje su veoma blizu, to su parohija Svetog Ilije i parohija Svetog Save koja je tu veoma blizu. Ima dosta ljudi koji još žive tu relativno blizu, nekih desetak milja odavde. tu je i sveštenik otac Aleksandar koji nas je dočekao i u principu ovde se ljudi znaju, to su generacije, već druga ili treća generacija koji žive ovde već 40-50 godina, svi se znaju, tako da je vrlo lako da dođete do kontakata, da razglasite ovakve akcije, onda je vrlo lako u stvari organizovati se i prikupiti sredstva za ljude kojima je stvarno potrebna pomoć.
Interesantno, tu ima ljudi koji su, možda su rođeni ovde, nisu bili, možda neki nikada, ili nisu bili godinama tamo, ali došli njihove babe i dede, ali žele došli otvorena srca da pomognu.
Da, ovde je u stvari naša crkva sačuvala potpuno identitet naroda, kroz ne samo osnovne liturgije na koje idemo svake nedelje, pokušavamo da idemo u crkvu i što više možemo, ali je crkva stvarno očuvala i učenje jezika i održavanje nekih kulturnih manifestacija, tako da su ljudi prilično povezani i čuvaju taj svoj identitet, iako su već recimo treća generacija, neki od njih ne govori jezik, ali neki od tih koji ne govori jezik svoju decu šalju na srpski u škole srpskog, tako da mogu da nauče i da nastave da čuvaju sve tradicije.
Iako ne govori jezik, možda će dati među najvećim donacijama.
Može da se desi, da, da.
Nadam. Videli smo i vaše prezime na listi tamo, šta ste izabrali ovoga puta?
Da, uzeli smo one krevete na sprat sa dušicima za decu, zato što će to ići sigurno deci. I to su, mi nekad biramo tu, a nekad jednostavno damo i donaciju van toga, znači uvek u ovoj organizaciji može da se da i van ovakvih akcija, što se i dešava, mi imamo najviše takvih donacija u stvari od donatora, međutim na ovakvim skupovima ljudi mogu da vide uživo prvo gde novac ide, kako se koristi, kome je to stvarno potrebno i ono što je važno za našu organizaciju, mi vrlo često i čak većinu sredstava odnosimo na Kosovo i Metohiju gde je ogromna potreba za pomoć i zato što oni vrlo često budu zaboravljeni i ja mislim da je njima preko potrebno da se pomogne i da im se, da se čuje njihov glas. Jer nekad prosto, računamo, dobro, to je bilo u vestima, šta više, jedno čak sam čuo jednu gospođu koja je jednom prokomentarisala, pa šta više za njih. Jer onda kada je čula prezentaciju i kada je videla na jednoj od prethodnih događaja, na jednom prethodnih događaja koliko je u stvari ljudi koji su potpuno nesrećeni, koji nemaju ništa, onda se potpuno promenila priča i počele su da pristižu mnogo veće donacije.
Šta vas motiviše da budete u našim Srbima i da dajete donacije? Svi su ljudi ovde zauzeti, obično velika vožnja, znači treba baš imati veliko srce i odvojiti vreme i napor za sve ovo.
Dobro, sve, mislim, svi mi imamo obaveza, to je normalno, ali svi moramo i da imamo nekakav društveno korisna hobi. Ja se recimo u slobodno vreme bavim sajtom svetosavlje.org, ali pored to i tada sam shvatio stvari koliko ljudi mogu mnogo da urade kada odvoje malo svog vremena, koje jeste dragoceno, ali zaista može nevjerojatno mnogo da se postigne sa malom pomoći i finansijskom i odvajanjem vremena. Ljudi ne shvataju da u stvari kad se mnogo nas udruži ne treba tu mnogo truda da se učini dosta.
Da li bi trebalo, evo nekad kažu da se ima 300-500 hiljada u Čikagu, da možda da bude i više ljudi, ili možda neko nije mogao da dođe zbog posla, zbog obaveza, a mogu pomoći, mogu kasnije postati pomoć?
Naravno, mi imamo website koji odlično funkcioniše, postoje linkovi na websiteu gde može da se uplati pomoć, znači ne mora za ovaj konkretno projekt, imamo i drugih projekata, a može da se daje generalna donacija i to će ići, na primer, najčešće deca koje prime paketiće tamo oko Božića, to nam je jedan od najlepših događaja, mi skupljamo ogromne sredstva takođe za garderobu, za igračke, na primer. Imali smo problema i administrativnih, na primer, i to je nešto što bi moglo da nam pomogne, dešavalo se da su nam sa granice vratili donacije, jer nešto nije izgledalo novo, na primer. Ceo kontejner, jedan pomoć je vraćen bio jednom, tako da ima tu dosta i problema.
Granice Srbije ili?
Ne, bila je druga granica gore, to je bila luka, ja mislim, u Amsterdamu, u stvari na severu Holandije, tako da ima tu i raznih problema i druge vrste pomoći su nam neophodne. Znači, ljudi koji imaju konekcije, koji imaju veze, imali smo jednu donatorsku večeru pre nekih 2-3 godine, gde su drugi donirali ogromna sredstva, a mi smo samo, nas su samo pitali da obezbedimo novac za prevoz. I samo zahvaljujući jednoj donatorskoj večeri, ogromna sredstva su otišla u bolnice u Srbiji. Tako da, Ima milion načina, mogu ljudi da nas kontaktiraju, da nas pitaju kako mogu da pomognu. Ima milion ideja, naravno. I ima mnogo više toga što može se uradi nego što se postiže, ali uvek može bolje.
I ljudi u Srbiji nekad i misle možda da je ljudi u Americi lako da daju donacije i da to je tek tako, ali možda to i sve u svemu teži poduhvat nego što deluje sa strane.
Da, pa jednostavno drugačije su relacije. Ovde su... Na primjer, ljudi imaju ogromne kredite za stanove, za automobile, sve živo je na kredit. Neka to delo iz Srbije, oni primaju ne znam kolike plate, ali opet, čak i relativno mi bolje stojimo nego što je situacija u Srbiji, tamo je velika kriza, ljudi jednostavno nemaju novca da izdvajaju, ali ono što možemo, mi dajemo i vidimo dobre rezultate, zato što i kad odvojimo novac, to bi, ovde bi ova oprema za ove kuće koštala mnogo više. A opet tamo mi možemo 10 puta više da uradimo sa istom količinom novca koji bismo ovde potrošili za to isto. Tako da, zato gledamo da prikupimo sredstva i da onda na licu mesta kupimo, da onda biznisima u Srbiji damo ovaj određeni promet, zato što...
Mala injekcija,
upravo, da,
sredstava i tamo.
Jesu bitne i te naše injekcije, mi šaljamo novac, na primjer, kad ide rodbini ili prijateljima, to je sve važno, ali ovo je važno da mi, u stvari, srpskim biznisima, srpskim radnjama dajemo novac. Kad kupimo hranu, mi kupujemo u Srbiji, ne kupujemo ovde pa je šaljamo, nego uvek je to neka srpska kompanija, tako da sav novac ulazi u srpsku ekonomiju.
I Kate je rekla i Srbi za Srbe će se takođe sad uključiti i oni će jednu kuću inspirisani svim ovim napraviti.
Da, oni Srbi za Srbe su stvarno odlična organizacija koja dugo postoji i oni su čuli za ovu našu akciju i sad kreće takmičenje pa vidjet ćemo ko će ja pobediti.
To je lepo jedno takmičenje možda da ljudi, mislim uvijek je lep osjećaj, dati u stvari kažu i lepše nego primiti.
Upravo.
Tako da...
Da, upravo i to je i cilj, mi neke ljude i poznajemo iz te organizacije, tako da gledat ćemo da motivišemo jedni druge da što više uradimo što je moguće.
Šta vi poručujete svima koji možda još nisu se uključili i razmišljaju da se angažuju za naše Srbe i generalno da pomognu ljudima?
Da, neka prvo pogledaju naš sajt, na njemu postoji, nema mnogo da se čita, vrlo je sve jasno i objašnjeno, ali treba da se zamisle da li su uvek u životu sve imali, na primjer sad da su možda u dobroj situaciji, imaju i dobar smeštaj i hranu i sve što treba i za svoju decu, ali neka se sete kako je bilo, da li su uvek u životu sve imali i kako je bilo u tom periodu kad je bilo teže. Tako da, kad se toga prisete kako im je bilo, verovatno će da daju i drugima i da podele to sa drugima.
Imate još neki posebni pozdrav ili poruku?
Pa evo, mislim, svima u Srbiji bismo zahvalili, jer mi dobijamo stvarno mnogo poruka i neke od njih nas rastuže zato što su jezive situacije, ljudi koji su stvarno u teškoj materijalnoj situaciji, ali jednostavno ima nade, postoje načini da se pomogne svom narodu. Mi svi koji imamo ovde i potomstvo pokušavamo da održimo tu žicu nacionalne pripadnosti, da i naša deca ostanu u svemu tome, da razmišljaju o drugima, da ne budu sebični, nego da jednostavno uvek razmišljaju o nekom ko živi pored njih i ko može da živi bolje zahvaljujući nekoj maloj donaciji ili nečemu što su odvojili od svog slobodnog vremena.
Kathy Fenslow planira da putuje u Srbiju već u junu, nada se da uruči na licu mesta ključeve novim vlasnicima kuća u Medveđi. Iz Merrillvilla u severozapadnoj Indijani, Aleksandar Žigić.